Hi, Sujoy. Welcome to the Quint.
Hello.
And I'm going to start off by asking you, it's been almost 7 years since Kahaani, and that still remains an unforgettable experience for a viewer, you know, as a thriller. You know, the kind of audience reactions you got, the kind of box office success it went on to become. Looking back now, you know, 7 years later, you've made Kahaani 2, and now you're all set with Badla. Do you feel that Kahaani has become something that you need to live up to?
Yeah, Kahaani did change a lot of things for me. I mean, I am, to a certain extent, what I am because of Kahaani. So I cannot deny that. But at the same time, I think I'm also trying to veer out a little. I don't want Badla to come with the baggage of Kahaani. Because that's an independent film, and I have put in a lot of hard work on Badla. So I hope it stands as an independent film. But that inevitable comparison is always there, you know, like, but I guess that's what we signed up for. So I'm okay with it. No, it's okay. But ideally, no, I wouldn't want to live under the shadow of Kahaani.
There's nothing that you can do about it.
I can't. So if I have to live under the shadow of some film, so Kahaani be it.
Okay. Now, I saw the trailer, and a lot of people saw the trailer, 24 million views.
Yeah.
It's slick, it's great, and it's, you know, does the right thing to sort of prick your interest. How tricky is it to edit the trailer of a mystery whodunit? Because one, you cannot give out too much information, but at the same time, you have to give enough information so that it hooks your audience and makes them invest in, you know, wanting to watch the film.
I guess, you know, it's a trial and error process, Suresh. I'm to be honest, there's no process to it. There's no science to it. So you keep cutting it and you keep, you know what your story is, right? So, you know, this is what I want to tell Suresh. So at least Suresh has some curiosity value to come back. And then you start cutting it. And sometimes, oh, kuch zyada hi bol diya. Oh, ye wala shot nahi chalega. For example, when I shot Kahaani, I cheated a little. So I knew I had, because I was making a film like Kahaani, I needed something which will make people sit up. So I did that whole push. Which, in a way, I had the trailer in mind. But when I was shooting Badla, I didn't really have a trailer in mind, you know. So I really didn't shoot it like that. And now, but inevitably, what we got out from the film, I'm very happy with, you know. It just managed to, I'm hoping it managed to invoke a lot of the right response.
Now, Badla is based on Oriel Poelo's story. Have you remained loyal to the original story, or have you made some twists and turns of your own to the plot when you adapted it as your screenplay?
This is why it took me a while to wrap my head around it, because, you know, as a director, my job description is to tell a story. So when you give me a story, I'm very happy. I get to tell it in a way I want, right? A book or a concept, I get to tell it. But when you tell me a story which already has been told and in a manner which is absolutely fabulous, you know, the best possible way this story could have been told, then it puts me in a quandary because I don't know how to better it. You know, I wouldn't know how to take that story, make it better. And so it took me a while to wrap my head around to it. And then I added my little two bits in terms of where I could, in terms of adapting it to a milieu which would be palatable for, first of all, for me as an Indian audience, and then my audience, who, you know, my mother, my aunt, who would identify with everything. So I think that's what I did. But more or less, you know, I had to be loyal to the original, because that is fabulous. You know, I cannot top something which is already fabulous. I think my test lies in whether I can keep you engrossed in a story which you have already heard before.
In today's age where social media is so prevalent and all over, does making a mystery whodunit sort of also make you a little nervous, because, you know, some mischievous guy out there may just leak the ending or some key point?
You know, I thought a lot through this. But this is the world we are living in. So you either adapt or you get out. You know, if you can't handle it, then I should be leaving this industry and say, no, what is this nonsense, you know? But this is the world, you know, we are living in. I mean, everybody has tool, everybody has a voice, everybody is entitled to do. So you have to then concentrate on the film that you make, and you hope, irrespective of everything, people would still come to see your film and come back again to see it again. And therein lies the challenge. The challenge doesn't lie in how do I fob off people who has access to information and may tweet my
ending out
or do this. I mean, that is limitless, there, Suresh. That, you know, people can do whatever they want. I mean, that is limitless. But I need to focus on what I'm making, and I need to focus on hopefully making a good product which you would be interested in seeing. And if you like my product, see, again, most of the films that I made, be it Chankar, be it Kahani, be it Ahalya, it's the audience which made it work. I don't know when a movie works or not. I don't know that formula, right? I have no clue what makes a movie work. So every time as movie of mine has worked, like Kahani was pure audience-driven movie. Maine toh banaya tha, audience took it to other. Ahalya, same. So I'm hoping if this is good, it's the audience who takes it.
Okay, your obsession and love for Mr. Amitabh Bachchan is no secret. What's your earliest memory of seeing Mr. Bachchan on screen?
On screen?
Yeah, not in real. I'll come to that later.
Probably Namak Haram. Because I remember Namak Haram was on Doordarshan, Sunday. Saturday was Bangla, Sunday was Hindi. So, my dad was a huge fan of Sir. Huge fan. So, and I didn't want to see that film. You know, I didn't understand what was going on. And I least interested of sitting and watching some black and white film. But my dad said, no, wait. There'll be a very cool moment. And there was this really cool moment where this man just comes out in the middle of all these people and says, hey, koi mai ka lal jo maa ka doodh piya hai. So, my dad was very fascinated. Look. What a hero. So, and I saw that and I thought, wow, what a hero. And I still think, wow, what a hero.
And tell us about your first meeting with Mr. Bachchan and what went on.
With Sir?
Yeah.
What happened was I tried to get in touch with Sir in many forms and ways, but I couldn't because I don't know anybody.
This was before Jhankar or after?
It's sort of during Jhankar, after Jhankar. And nobody would, and I really genuinely didn't know how to approach him. And I remember Sir was shooting in Ravindya Natya Mandir. I can't remember whether it was Aankhe or Waqt. Either one of that Sir was shooting in Ravindya Natya Mandir. And by that time I was frustrated beyond my limits. So I just went in there. I just circumvented the security and he was just sitting there and I went and said, Sir, I said, hey, you, how did you get in? So...
No, what was the meeting about?
I wanted him to do Borivali.
Achha, okay.
So I had to introduce myself and say, I have a script called Borivali, will you please read it? And I swear, he gave me that amount of respect as if he knew me and he knew my work and I actually mattered, which he didn't have to. He could have called the security and said, who is this intruder on my set? Get him out. But, he actually allowed me an audience, which I thought was amazing. So I just walked in there and met him.
Okay, now my last question is, there's a lot of curiosity around fans. And there is a rumor that Mr. Shah Rukh Khan is in Badla. Ooh. Are you going to confirm that for us?
How to answer this question, I do not know. Yay, 8th March.
We'll have to wait till 8th March to know.
8th March, yeah, please wait. I'm nervous like shit, man. So please, you also share some of this palpitation with me.